Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to set up your Gmail account in Microsoft Outlook. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to my channel. Now in this guide, I'm going to show you two different ways that you can set up Gmail in Outlook. The first one is going to be an IMAP setup using the auto configuration settings of Microsoft Outlook. And the second way is going to be a POP3 setup, which is going to involve setting up Gmail manually in Microsoft Outlook. And there's a big difference between how your emails will operate in Microsoft Outlook if you use a POP3 setup versus the other methods. So to get started with the guide, to set up a Gmail account in Microsoft Outlook using the auto configuration settings, you can open up Outlook and then you can click on File, then click on Add Account. And then here you can enter your Gmail address and then you can click on Advanced Options and then choose Let me set up my account manually and then click on Connect. And then here in the advanced setup, you can choose Google. And it's going to load the Google sign-in screen. Enter your email address again. Click on Next. And then enter your normal Gmail password. You'll probably be prompted to verify this session on your cell phone. So you need to go ahead and do that. So I've just accepted the prompt on my cell phone. And the next step is you have to scroll down and then click on Allow. So you can give Microsoft Outlook permission to view the emails from Gmail. And once that's done, you should see this screen that says the account has been successfully added. So once that's done, you can click on Done. And then here in Outlook, you'll find your Gmail address added to its own mailbox. And here in the Gmail tab, if you click on that little arrow, it's going to expand all of the folders that you have created in Gmail. I don't have any custom folders set up. But if you have custom folders, you'll see them listed here. Now, just to show you what I mean by that, is if I go to Gmail online and I create a new label, and let's just call this label test, and then click on create, you'll see here under labels, I now have this label called test. And if I click on that, I'll see any emails that have been added to this label. So basically, this is a folder that I created. So if I go back to my inbox and I choose these first two mails and I click on move to and I select test, it's going to move those two emails to this test label or test folder, if you'd like to call it that. And now if we go back to Outlook and we click on send and receive all folders so it can start downloading the emails from my mailbox, you'll see that the test label or folder has now appeared here from Gmail, the one that I created on Gmail. So I'm just going to stop the syncing for now. But basically what I'm trying to explain to you is an IMAP setup, the way it's set up right now, is like a mirror of what you see on the online Gmail. Whatever you create here or whatever you see here will also be mirrored or synced to the IMAP setup that you have here in Outlook. Now next, to set up Gmail as POP3, first, you'll have to log into your Gmail account online, and then you need to click on your account icon up there, and then click on Manage your Google account. Next, you need to search your Google account for two-step, and you want to find the two-step verification option and then select that. Then scroll down and you need to click on Get Started, so you can enable two-step verification if it's not enabled yet. If it's enabled, you can skip this step. You can click on continue and then you need to enter your phone number here. Make sure that text message is selected and then click on send. And it's going to send you an SMS text message with a code that you have to enter here. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Then click on next. Then click on turn on. Now once two-step verification is turned on, you can click on back. And then you need to search the Google account again for app password. Then click on app passwords. Then you can create a new app password and you can give the app a name. I'm going to call this Outlook. And then click on create. And then it's going to generate this app password. You need to select this whole password and then you can right click on it and copy it. And don't copy anything else because we're going to need this in the setup. So next, do a search on your computer for the control panel. Then open the control panel app. Then here, just make sure that this view by setting is set to either large or small icons. And then on this list, you want to find this mail option and then click on that. Next, you need to click on email accounts. And then here, you need to click on new. And then you need to add a new mail account. Now here, you need to click on manual setup or additional server types. Then click on next. Click on POP or IMAP. Then click on next. And then here, you need to fill out all of your details. So I'm going to fill my name out as memory. I'm going to enter my email address. And then here, you need to make sure that this is set to POP3, which is the default. The incoming mail server is pop.gmail.com. And the outgoing mail server is smtp.gmail.com. And then the username here should be your full Gmail address. And then this password is the app password that you just created. So you can press Ctrl and V on your keyboard to paste the app password that you generated with Google. You can go back to the setup. You can leave this box checked and you can leave it to add a new Outlook data file. Next, you need to click on more settings. Then click on outgoing server. Make sure that this box is checked, that your outgoing server requires authentication, and leave all of the other settings on default. Then click on advanced. Here in the incoming server, you need to select this checkbox that says the server requires an encrypted connection. If you select that, the port's going to change to 995. It has to change to 995. If yours doesn't, make sure the port is 995 and this option is selected. For the outgoing server, here where it says use the following type of encrypted connection, click on the drop-down and select SSL or TLS, and then change this port to 465. And then here, you can choose to leave a copy of your emails on the Gmail server. I recommend that you leave this checked. And then you can also remove it from the server after 14 days. Gmail gives you 15 gigabytes of free space for your emails. So normally when I set up Gmail as POP3, I uncheck this setting. So I do leave a copy of the messages on the server, but it doesn't get removed from the Gmail server. But do keep in mind, over a certain period of time, your Gmail account might get full and you'll need to delete some of the older emails by going to the Gmail online and then deleting the emails from here. But to continue with the guide, you can check this option that says remove from server when deleted from deleted items. Basically, when you delete it from the trash bin inside of Outlook, it'll also be deleted from Gmail online. So once this is all set up, you can click on OK. Then you can click on next. It's going to do a test. And both of these should pass if you set it up correctly. And once that's done, you can click on close and then just make sure that this box is unchecked. Click on finish. And now if we open Outlook, you'll see that I have another account here, another Gmail account, which also has the normal folders like inbox and sent items, outbox and all of that. But you'll notice that there's no test folder or test label like I have here in the IMAP setup, because POP3 doesn't work like a sync or a mirror between Outlook and Gmail, and it works both ways. If I were to create a new folder here in the POP3 setup labeled test 2, this folder will never show up in the online version of Gmail. But if I were to create it here in the IMAP setup, it will show up on the online version of Gmail. Now, the advantage you have when using POP3 is generally that the emails will download faster and you won't get a sync issue when syncing the Gmail emails to Outlook. It can happen that sometimes with an IMAP setup, the syncing just takes forever and it never seems to complete. But with a POP3 setup, you don't have that issue. And there's also a difference between how the emails are saved on your computer. So if we go back to the control panel to mail and we go to data files, if we have a look at these data files that we have here, you'll see I have three OST files, .ost files, and I have one .pst file. So basically these OST files are online storage files. It's only like a cache for your emails that's saved on this computer. But a PST file is a personal storage file which has all of your emails saved on your computer. So you have offline copies of all of your emails. So this is great for if you want to make backups of your emails and save them on external drives or just have offline copies of your emails. Now, one quick tip I just want to give you if you are going to use the POP3 setup is go back to the email tab and then select your Gmail POP setup. And here in the username at the start, type the word recent. with a colon. So the username reads recent colon and then your Gmail address. The reason for this is just so that you receive every single email that is sent to your Gmail address in Outlook, because it happens sometimes that Outlook might miss some emails, but if you add this recent keyword right there, it'll download every single email that you have in your Gmail inbox. So I'll just click on next and it's going to do another test. So you'll see that it still works if you add the word recent there. And once that's done, you can click on close and then on finish, and you can close all of this and you can go ahead and use Gmail in Outlook. But I hope this guide's been informative and that you understood the points that I was trying to make between the two different setups. If you have any questions, just leave a comment down below and I'll try my best to answer all of those. But if this guide helped you out, please like the video and I'll see you in the next one.